बेल्लारी राजा
बेल्लारी राजा अल्लरे एन्नूरी राजा निंदेकी एल्लिया लूरा मन्नर राजा यंदर डाई आज आड़ी आदि नापरम प्याज
अब हम पुलिया नेटा.
Hello, my dear students. This is Vishwas, and today we will be looking at a panther. Huh? Black panther as in the Avengers series? No, this is a Dalit panther, Namdev Dasal. Dasal was a Dalit poet and a militant political activist who grew up near Golpita, which is adjacent to Mumbai's infamous red light district, Kamathipura. He had rubbed shoulders with notorious gangsters as well as the top political leadership of Maharashtra. He has been awarded a Padma Shri and is rated highly among contemporary Marathi writers. Dasal is arguably one of the major world poets of the 20th century. His poetry is very striking and complex. Let me just give you a brief introduction to Dalit literature. The caste system in India denied the Dalits the pen. It was when social reformers and poets like Anna Bhav Sathe, who is credited as the founding father of Dalit literature, then Babu Rao Bagul, Shantabai Kamble, and Namdev Dasal, to name a few, snatched the pen and used it to record the pain of millions silenced by the caste politics, that the Dalit history began to exist in written form, from merely being oral accounts. The Dalit voice began to reach the various parts of the country when they took upon themselves to record their stories, which were earlier narrated by people who had no experiential connection with them. Dalit literature is literature written by Dalits about their lives. Dalit literature emerged in the 1960s in the Marathi language, and it soon appeared in Bangla, Hindi, Kannada, Punjabi, Telugu, Tamil, and Malayalam. Through narratives such as poems, short stories, and autobiographies, which stood out due to their stark portrayal of reality and the Dalit political scene. Dalit literature denounced the then prevailing portrayal of life by mainstream Marathi literature. Modern Dalit writing only emerged as a distinct genre after the democratic and egalitarian thinkers such as Srinarayana Guru, Jyotiba Phule, B.R. Ambedkar, Yoti Thas, Sahodaran Ayyappan, Ayyangali, Poigai Lappachan, and others began to articulate the sources and modes of caste oppression. In 1958, the term Dalit literature was used at the first conference of Maharashtra Dalit Sahitya Sangha in Mumbai. Dalit literature started being mainstream in India with the appearance of the English translations of Marathi Dalit writing. The process of the Dalits telling their own stories is vital to cleansing the ugliness of the society. No poet told stories so heart-wrenching and honest than Namdev Dasal, who thundered into the Dalit literary scene with Golpita, his first poetry collection published in 1971. Golpita is named after the notorious center of prostitution in central Mumbai. He grew up in Dhorchal in the Arab Gali near Golpita, the black hole of Mumbai's traditional red light district. This was the heart of Mumbai's underworld, and even today possesses the characteristics of a neighborhood where everything illicit, criminal, nefarious, exploitative, and inhuman finds a natural home. Born into a slum in Bombay, Namdev Dasal knew what survival was and fought for the rights of his people. Golpita was the symbol of an inhumane reality transformed through poetic imagination. Otherwise untouched by the eyes and imagination of Brahmin Marathi writers in Maharashtra, Dasal told through his poems of life that can be found at any level. It provided Dalits the confidence with which they can now explore the language for their struggle, without being burdened by norms and oppressive tradition. With the arrival of Golpita, Dalits in Maharashtra not only got their language, but also the theory for their experiences by which they can now tell the world that they are the creators of their lives. Since then, Dasal has inspired many poets. His influence on the form of poetry that is being practiced in Maharashtra continues till today. Perhaps no other poet in the history of Maharashtra has wielded as much influence as Dasal. His vision about life, his struggle, and his poetry were the factors that prevented his influence from waning in the public imagination. Namdev Dasal was one of the founders of Dalit Panthers in 1972, a militant activist organization inspired by the Black Panthers in the United States of America. You must have heard of the Black Panthers as a part of Marvel's Avengers film series. That name was inspired from the revolutionary organization that was active in USA from the 1960s to 1980s. But the Dalit Panthers were rooted in Bombay and were the product of the history of the city and the immigrant Dalit youth who came to it, scarred by the memories of their oppression in their native villages and small towns, and inspired by their late leader, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar. Namdev Dasal was born into the Mahar caste, but converted to Buddhism, inspired by B.R. Ambedkar. The movement was launched in 1956 by Ambedkar, when nearly 500,000 Dalits, formerly untouchables, joined him and converted to Navayana, means new vehicle. It's a different sect in Buddhism. It rejected Hinduism, challenged the caste system in India, and promoted the rights of the Dalit community. Following Ambedkar, many Maharashtrian Dalits had quit Hinduism to liberate themselves from a caste system that stamped them with a lifelong lowly status. They were uncomfortable with any kind of Hindu cultural and political rhetoric. They were looking for a platform in their fight for equality and freedom. There was an articulate Dalit avant-garde that stormed the Marathi literary scene and attracted nationwide attention. Now, what do you mean by avant-garde? Avant-garde was originally a French term, meaning in English, it means vanguard or advance guard. Advance guard is that part of an army. This term comes from military. So it's that part of the army that goes forward ahead of the rest. പട്ടാളത്തിലത്തെ മറ്റ് യോദ്ധാക്കളൊക്കെ പോകുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് മറ്റ് പട്ടാളക്കാർ പോകുന്നതിന് മുമ്പ് ആദ്യം പോകുന്ന ഒരു ഗ്രൂപ്പിനെയാണ് അവരാണ് ആ ഇത് നയിക്കുന്നത്. അതുപോലെ തന്നെ സാഹിത്യത്തിലും കലയിലും ഒക്കെ പുതിയ കാര്യങ്ങൾ തുടങ്ങുന്ന വിപ്ലവാത്മകമായിട്ടുള്ള കാര്യങ്ങൾ തുടങ്ങുന്ന ആളുകളെ ഒരു ഒരു കൂട്ടത്തിനെയാണ് ഈ അവാൻഗാർഡ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. അവർ തുടങ്ങി വയ്ക്കുകയാണ്, ഒരു പുതിയൊരു രീതി തുടങ്ങുകയാണ്. അതിനെയാണ് നമ്മൾ അവാൻഗാർഡ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. ദ ഗ്രേറ്റ് ഫിക്ഷൻ റൈറ്റർ ബാബുറാവ് ബാഗുൾ ഹാഡ് ഓൾറെഡി മെയ്ഡ് ഹിസ് മാർക്ക്. നാംദേവ് ദസൽ, രാജാ ധാലെ, അർജുൻ ദാംഗ്ലെ ആൻഡ് ജെ വി പവർ were all young writers who wanted to shake the Marathi literary establishment at its very foundations and had in them the spirit and the talent to do so. They wanted to take their activism, beyond literature and culture directly into the political arena. So this was also a political movement. Yet they also knew from the outset that as a minority, they would only be small-time players in electoral politics or even be made mere stooges. They found guerrilla tactics a very attractive weapon in the ethos of the big city, where the poorer neighborhoods were ruled by organized crime and where politicians used the underworld as a source of secret weapons. The Dalit Panthers began a new social movement by combining the teachings of Ambedkar, Jyotiba Phule, Karl Marx and Lenin. In the following decades, Dalit writing became an all-India phenomenon. This writing reformulates the caste question, reassesses the significance of colonialism, and exposes the contemporary workings of caste power. The Dalit Panthers helped invigorate the use of the term Dalit to refer to the lower caste communities. So that's a very important legacy that this movement has. The use of the word Dalit. Their manifesto issued in 1973 fit the Ambedkarite spirit into a broader Marxist framework and heralded the rise of an autonomous Dalit perspective in post-independent India. Dasal was greatly inspired by the work of Babu Rao Bagul, who employed photographic realism to draw attention to the circumstances which those deprived of their rights from birth have to endure. Dasal's poems broke away from stylistic conventions. He included in his poetry many words and expressions which only the Dalits normally used. In Golpita, for instance, he adapted his language to that of the red light district, which shocked middle-class readers. His poetry is both a translator's nightmare and occasional delight, as people unfamiliar with the nuances of Marathi language and culture might miss the point. For Dasal, politics and art were inextricably linked. He stated, "Poetry is politics." Dasal adhered to this principle in his private life. It's not for his politics that Namdev Dasal will be remembered. Not perhaps even for the Dalit Panthers. He will be remembered for his maverick spirit and for the poetry that will leave you breathless. Dasal died in Mumbai in 2014. In the next video, we will be looking at Dasal's politically charged poem, "Stonemasons, My Father and Me."
Oh. Nammal oru varavude varendi veri.